you just want to use Pandas DataReader 0.7.0 to get multiple stock data from Yahoo Finance. You don't need that many setup if you use Google Colab. I just want to save my files to my local machine. That's why I set it up in Sublime Text on Windows 10. Before I move on, I just jot down some notes. The Python version that I'm using is 3.7.2, and the Pandas version that works is 0.24.2. When you create a brand new virtual environment, you will have Pandas version 0.25. If you use that version, you can't get it to work. So let me just wipe up everything, rebuild it again, and show it to you. Let's dive in. So let me just go to CMD, command prompt. Simply remove my virtual environment first. Are you sure? Yeah. Then when I go back to D drive, I shouldn't see my environment. So you can see test 372. Let me just create that, redo it again. Okay, so let's pretend that we restart it, create a virtual environment with python-m and then when, and I just called it test 372. So you should be able to see test 372 folder here in the D drive. In your case, it may be different. Okay, let me just go to D drive, test 372, and then scripts. I'm not sure if I can do activate here, activate.bat. nope. Yeah, but I can still do it this way. Test 372. I've just created the environment test 372. I should expect to see a scripts folder. Inside the scripts folder, I should see the Python execute file here. When I type where Python, I should... Oh, how come there's only one? Oh, because I didn't activate. No wonder. Go to scripts and then activate.bat. Oops. How come? Inside the scripts folder, simply activate.bat. Then you should see you're inside the environment. So when you type where Python, you should see two execute folder address. One is your default Python execute file address, and the other one is the environment's execute file address. Let's clear everything. Okay, let me just get back to the command prompt and show it to you how I do it. So usually cd dash and then type location test 372 and go to the scripts folder first and then activate. Then you should be able to see the virtual environment. Then let me do pip list to see what we get. Actually, we should have very few Python packages here. Let me just upgrade pip. Just do python dash m pip install double dash upgrade pip, and it should be, yep, upgrading to 19.2. When I run piplist inside the environment, I should see pip 19.2. It's totally optional, but usually I will upgrade the pip because I just feel better if I get the updated pip. Okay, so it's 19.2. I just go for what I did a few minutes ago, which didn't work, and then I'll show you how to fix it. So I should install Pandas, right? Just remember what I said. I should use Pandas version 0.24.2 instead of the latest 0.25 if you want Pandas DataReader 0.7.0 to work. So Pandas DataReader should be the latest one, 0.7. I'm not sure if I can skip the steps by just pip install Pandas DataReader 0.7. Let me just try it now. Just do pip install Pandas DataReader. Yep, seems like it works. Yeah, it's installing Pandas here. You need Pandas and NumPy. Let me run pip list. And you see here, Pandas version 0.0.5 doesn't work. I tried it before. I'll show you why. Python and then import pandas as pd and then pd.core.common is list like. This one doesn't work. I'm just showing you the error message that you will expect. api.types.is list like. And when you do import pandas data reader as web, you will see this. This is the error message that you see if you have pandas 0.25. So let me just change pandas back to 0.24.2, okay? Pip install pandas equals 0.24.2. Just tried it. Oh yeah, I should mean double. Doesn't matter. Pip install pandas double equal sign 0.24.2. I'm using 0.24.2 instead. Okay, so when you run pip list, you will see pandas version 0.24.0. So let me just try it this way. Pandas as pd.core.common.is is like equals pd.api.types.is list like. You need this long line before you import pandas data reader. Pandas data reader as web. Yes, no error message now. I think I can just do it here, just quicker. So I'm going to get two stock data at once from Yahoo Finance using Pandas Data Reader. Now I need data, I remember, so just call it DT. I'm going to get the SPDR goal, which is GLD, and Dow Jones DJI. So I'm just showing you how I look up for the stock symbol. I just call it SPDR goal and then Yahoo Finance. You can fill in whatever stock symbol that you can find from Yahoo Finance. I'm just picking this as an example. Okay, so you see SPDR. You can look up for the stock by just typing this. So you see GLD, SPDR goal share, and this one for DJI, Dow Jones Industry Average. Okay. And the start date, I just pick whatever day, 1986, Jan 1st. End day is today, okay, just up to this moment. dt.daytime.today. I'm going to store it in the table. Just call it df, and it's going to grab the data from web that we defined here, right? Pandas data reader as web, and then we use their data reader method. Then we can start filling in the stock, and then the method that we use is Yahoo from start to end date. Yep, no problem. Good. And let me just show you what I get. Just print the first five column, right? So this is the data that you get. For high, you have two columns, goal and Dow Jones, low and Dow Jones DJI. Let me print the latest 5 days. It should be better because you see some of the NAN here, okay? So these are the data. Oh, actually, you know what? Let me just exit, deactivate that. Let me show you how to set up in Sublime Text. Let me just copy everything here. When you go to Tools, Build System, and then you press New Build System, you will see this. Then simply Ctrl V, paste this one. Just follow this code. That's how I get it to work. The only thing you need to change is this part. You need to fill in the path. I assume that you are using Windows 10, right? So you need \ for the directory, and then fill in the path that you store your file. This one, test372scripts-execute file, is just the path of your virtual environment. Let me show you which one. Yeah, this is purely optional. If you know your path, you don't need to type this, okay? So let me just go to test372. And then, oh, sorry. CD scripts, forgot. Always forgot that. Actually, activate. Once you get into your virtual environment, simply type where-, and then you see this. D drive test 372, which is the environment's name. It may be different on your side. Scripts folder, and then python.exe, which is exactly the same as this one. except that the directory is presented in double slash instead of single slash here, okay? So once you get that, Control S to save, and then you just save to a new Sublime build file. Let's say I just save it as test372. Then you just go to a new file, Control N. So you got a new untitled file, right? Then press Control S to save, and then just pick whatever location. I usually pick the environment location. So I go back to test372, and then I just save it as test, just call it mytest.py. Save it in Python, then you can import pandas as PD. Oh, you know what? I forgot to go to tools, build system, and then specify, you see the tick? I just take the build file that I just create, okay? And then I just run, you can just press Control B. Can I do Control B? Yeah, then you see build input, actually it's running. Just quickly show it here, just pd.or. It's a little bit different from the command prompt that I just showed you. API.types.list. I need the daytime as DT. The stock that I need is gold, GLD, SPDR gold, and Dow Jones. Okay. Oh, actually, I remember why I prefer this way. Because I can save the file to my local machine instead of uploading everything to the cloud, which I don't feel very comfortable with. So the start day is today. Usually, I'll use pd.todaytime to make it a daytime object, and then I put in a day, specific day of the start day that I'm going to start to get my stock later. And the end date is today, so I have daytime, right? pt.daytime.today. And then I'm going to save it in a table called df. I forgot the pandas data reader. So I have to import pandas data reader as web. That's why I can use the web. And then I use the data reader method to get the stock, which is a list of these two stocks, and then I use Yahoo. Then I'm going to get from the start date to the end day. So let me just print the latest 5 days. Control boy. No to daytime. Oh, typo. Day ein to be daytime. Okay, Control B. Oh, actually, you know what? When you scroll up here, you can't view all the data, right? So you see the dots. Usually I will do pd.setOptions, use the display.max columns. So that's the maximum number of columns that you can show. So I just put like 100 columns. That's not a colon. That should be a comma. And the second attribute is I want column width to be a little bit bigger. So display.columnWidth. If you forgot, you can always go back to the documentation. It doesn't matter. How about width? This time it should work. Yeah. So you see, it's much better, right? So the width should be longer. Let's make it 1000. Yeah. So basically what you can see is for the attribute high, you have two columns, right? Gold and then Dow Jones, or low, and then you have gold, Dow Jones, something like that. If you want to access one of them, let's say if I want to access the last five columns of Dow Jones low, then what I can do is df, which is the table, and then I call from the attribute, which is low, try Dow Jones first, and then I try low. Maybe the other way around. Oh no, actually that's the other way around. I change it back to low, and then DJI, control boy. Yeah, so that's Dow Jones' latest 5 columns. Now, let's say if I want to save it to my local machine, then what I can do is, I just call it location, whatever. Let me just call it D drive. Just save it to D drive, and then result.csv. So I just export that to CSV. You can export that file in Excel. Yeah, it's totally up to you, but I use CSV because just to save space. Then what I can do is df, which is the table that we got, right? df.to.csv bracket. If you use Excel, then you can do to Excel, but you may need the package XLRD or OpenPyXL. I don't remember. But in this case, I just save it to CSV, which is simpler. And then I save it to the location. So let's run it. Control boy. Okay, let me see if I get it. So if I go to D drive, I see the result.csv. Let me see if I can open it. Okay, let's open that. If you have Excel, use Excel. If you don't, just use the LibreOffice account. Control O. Let me open the result.csv. Yeah, whatever. Too bad. You know what? I used the wrong delimiter. Let me just do it again. Select result. Delimiter should be tab, comma. Yeah, comma. Then you see this, right? Then this time it should be way better. Basically, that's how you can download multiple stock data from Yahoo Finance with Pandas DataReader 0.7.0 on Windows 10. So hopefully it helps. Thank you. Bye-bye.